Let me start this by saying that GameCube is one of my favorite consoles. It was back in the day, and it is now. But that doesn't mean that it doesn't have games so bad that even thinking about some of them brings out my inner Australian boomerang throwing, drop bear tackling, Vegemite eating rage. Okay. I compiled this list of games from GameCube exclusive titles, meaning these games were only released on the Nintendo GameCube and no other platform. I didn't want to take the easy street and pick cross-platform games, even if they were a little worse on the GameCube, and trust me, that wasn't easy. I seriously considered putting Aquaman on this list regardless, because that piece of shit Superman 64 clone deserves to be on every top 5 worst list there is ever. And another reason making this list wasn't easy was because as far as exclusives went on the Nintendo GameCube, most of them were at least decent at best. Nintendo didn't mess around when it came to exclusives, but when they did, let's just get started. Number 5, PN3. Now, for those of you who have actually played this game, bear with me here because I have a reason for putting it on the list, and it's not because it's the worst game ever made. I'll preface this by saying that it's not the worst game ever made, so let me explain why it's on this crappy list. PN3 has an extremely cool concept. Much like Devil May Cry and Bayonetta in its feel, it's extremely stylistic, but it is unfinished, and you can feel that from the moment you take control of the gameplay. The levels all look the same, they all feel the same, it's extremely repetitive, it controls really badly, you can't move and shoot at the same time, which I hate in most of any game. The game is supposed to flow well, and it just doesn't. She was obviously supposed to be elegant and ballerina-like and gracious, but she has about as much grace and charm as Konami does these days. Although, I will say, there are some things about this game that I actually enjoy, which is what sets it apart to other games on this list. You know, it's interesting, the animations of the characters are pretty good, it's not Aquaman, but honestly, there is certainly worse games that deserve to be on the list. I've put it here purely out of disappointment, you could say, for the game. This could have been one of those games that years later, after the GameCube's lifespan has come to an end, and you hear people talking crap about the GameCube, you could say, but that PN3 though. But instead, we have this. I am truly sorry, PN3. Could have been great. Number 4, Monsters Incorporated Scream Arena.
Monsters Incorporated!
A dodgeball game? Why? They had so much to work with, honestly. Most movie games end up being an action-adventure type game, and sure, it usually sucks, but they at least have a little bit of depth to them. Monsters, Inc.? Think about that movie. You have those doors that go anywhere. The possibilities you could use there. Make a portal game with those doors. Or a puzzle game where you try to navigate your way through the doors, trying to complete tasks and objectives, but you never know where you're gonna end up. There's a concept there. There is something other than dodgeball. The animation is choppy, it sounds horrendously headache-inducing, the whole game is one long mini-game, this is all it is dodgeball level after level after level of the same crap. Hey yo, Monsters Incorporated, you know what, I have an idea. You want to make kids scream? Have them play this game for 10 minutes, you can retire all the monsters and have unlimited energy for the rest of forever. This game sucks. Next. Number 3. Yu-Gi-Oh! This game has no style, no grace, no intelligence, and so to do it any kind of justice, then I have to do the same for this review and just do it in one take and get out everything I need to say about this game so I don't miss anything. This is not Yu-Gi-Oh! For those of you that grew up on the cartoon with me, remember how awesome it was when the show started and you heard Yu-Gi-Oh! And you knew you were in for a great time? Well, every time you take this game, this disc, and you put it into your GameCube and you hit power on, you know you're about to have the worst time of your life. There's no Yu-Gi-Oh! In this at all. It's not Yu-Gi-Oh! It's a shitty, very shitty, dulled down Final Fantasy, turn-based RPG type game with tower defense elements. You don't card battle at all. There is no cards. It's Yu-Gi-Oh! Without cards. It's extremely repetitive. It's all the same. Same background, same animations. It looks like complete shit. You just battle slowly, really slowly. You can't skip any of the long-ass, boring animations, so every battle drags out and is the exact same every time. It's really boring. Story sucks. Game sucks. I'm gonna calm down for the next one.
I did that in one take, though. That was pretty good. I'm happy with that. Next, number two, MC's Grooves Dance Craze.
Okay, I'll make this one quick so we don't have to look at this game for too long because it's seriously an eyesore. It's a DDR type game. You have a dance mat and you have to step to the beat. Except in this version, it's incredibly easy. Even on expert, it's insanely easy. It features the same animation the whole time. It's just this, always, and forever this. It gets extremely repetitive and dull. It has full versions of songs. There's a song that lasts 12 minutes. Imagine doing this while looking at this for 12 fucking minutes. The dance mat it came with is made of cheap materials, it's bulky and crap. There's absolutely no effort put into this game whatsoever and was an obvious attempt at a cash grab due to the popularity of these games back in the day and...
Oh wait, is that DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince?
I take it all back, this game is amazing. That's amazing right there, that's a good song. I wouldn't want to dance to it. All across the land. There's no need to
argue. Parents just don't understand. Number one. Yeah, Universal Studios.
The reason I made this entire list, the reason I made this whole video, is honestly just so I can bitch about this game for a few minutes. It's not only the worst GameCube game I have ever played, but the worst game I have ever played in my life. Let me paint you a story real quick of 11-year-old me renting this game from Blockbuster for the first time. I need to get this off my chest. Since an early age, I had discovered the wonderful world of video games. For as long as I can remember, gaming has been a part of my life. And as a kid, every video game was the best thing I've ever played. I remember I had a demo of Mega Man X. It was just the first level, but I would play it over and over and over and over because, well, it was Mega Man freaking X, and because that's all I had, and because I was a kid. I could play anything. I had the best time. Video games were awesome. I couldn't even conceive of the fact that a video game could be bad. Then, one day, I went to my local Blockbuster with my friend. We always went there every weekend and we rented a game that we would inevitably finish that weekend. This day, we were stuck for ideas. We had played every game and finished every multiplayer game this Blockbuster had to offer. It came down to two single player games. Our two choices were Tie the Tasmanian Tiger and Universal Studios. I picked Universal Studios because I figured it would have more playability for two people. It'd take turns in the different theme parks. Now, the game sounded amazing. A theme park full of the best Universal movies of all time and you can play and interact with all of them? Are you kidding me? Well, before you do any of that, you need to pick up, like, a ton of rubbish and put it in the bin. Or for Americans, sorry, trash, and you put it in the trash can. Then, once you've deposited all the trash, you use your trash points to buy hats. To get into the rides? Okay. Well, at least we can actually play the fun part of the game now, right? We've spent like an hour picking up a ridiculous amount of rubbish and putting it into countless bins. What's that? The trash was the fun part of the game? All these games suck. They are all horrible, horrible mini games that are all super short, extremely short, minutes, seconds long. So most of your time playing this game is picking up trash and putting it in the bin. It's Side of the Highway Community Service Simulator, the game. And I rented this as a kid to play with my friend. He didn't want to play it. He watched me play it for like an hour or two and then we returned the game. I honestly still can't believe how bad this game is. I hate it. It makes me seriously upset, mad, angry. This was the first game I ever hated. I was so angry. I can't explain it. I didn't even spend my own money on this garbage, but It tore down my wall of illusion, the illusion that bad video games didn't exist. This was a hard taste of reality for me, that video games in general could be so horrible, that they are literally unplayable. I made my mother take my friend and I back to Blockbuster. It was the first game I ever returned. We switched it for Tyler Tasmanian Tiger in the end, which was amazing. But the best part was, the guy that worked there understood. He said it happens a lot with that game. I wonder how many kids that lived near that Blockbuster that lived near me had the same horrible memory of that game that I do. But hey, it's still not Aquaman. Okay, this game... Okay, I can't even make that... This game is worse than Aquaman. It's the worst fucking game! That's it. I'm done looking at this game.
That's all, guys. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Remember, you can click here to subscribe. You can click here for more videos. Hit that like button and leave a comment down below. You can tell me what your least favorite GameCube game was. There's a few more out there. But that is all, so I will catch you next time.